disquieting dots on the paper. But when people begin playing it...
So what is it specifically about this symphony that you love? You've worked with the European Union Youth Orchestra before. In fact, you've done a lot of work with youth orchestras. I know you conducted a National Youth Orchestra prom last year. Do you get a lot of satisfaction out of working with all this wonderful young talent? Now, it seems extraordinary, but this year you're celebrating your 80th birthday. Lots of celebrations planned. Any particular highlights that you're looking forward to? Sir Colin Davis talking to me just before rehearsals today. And with me again, Rob Cowan. But this was the story of the 16 Swans that Sibelius was witnessed from his window, I understand, just as he was about to start writing this symphony. So we've got a bit of a nature theme going on, Rob, haven't we, today?
Children. And there was a new...
And he lived until, what, nine?
But clearly, as a child growing up, it was one of those pieces...
It was meant to represent, wasn't it, that sort of journey through angst and then triumph at the end. You can definitely feel that tension, as you say. Do you think there are any parallels we can draw between the fact that Sibelius was writing this when he was about 50, a man in his prime, and Brahms, of course, wrote his third symphony when he was about the same age? Do you think we can see any similarities in the way they were writing?
I think that